Assalamu alaikum and hello everyone. This is Miraj Kamran in Explore Chemistry with another helpful video related to reactions of acids. In this video, I'm gonna tell you how acids react with different substances and how their chemical reactions take place. In this video, I'll tell you how to write an equation for these chemical reactions. So let's start. First of all, we will discuss reaction of acid with bases. In my previous videos, I have told you that bases are those substances which can donate hydroxyl ion in water or in any chemical reaction which can accept proton according to Arrhenius and Bronsted-Lowry theories. So basically, bases are those substances which are having one metallic ion, that is cation, and hydroxyl anion, OH negative ion. So let's see how acids react with these bases. For example, HCl is an acid and sodium hydroxide, NaOH, is a base. When these two react with each other, hydrogen combines with OH ion, hydroxyl ion of base, and negative ion of acid combines with positive ion of base. Simply here, double displacement reaction is taking place. They both are switching their partners or their radicals. So, if double displacement reaction takes place, the compound which will form or product which will form will be NaCl, which is a salt, and HOH or H2O, which is the formula of water. This type of reactions are called as neutralization reaction, because the product which have formed, NaCl and water, salt and water, both are neutral. Their pH value is 7, so they are considered as neutral. Because neutral products are forming, therefore this reaction is known as neutralization reaction. The pH of an acid is less than 7 and pH of base is greater than 7. By the reaction of these two reactants having different pH values, two neutral products are formed. Therefore, this reaction is known as neutralization reaction. Let's see another example, but this example is with acid with metallic oxide, because metallic oxides are basic in nature. So either acids react with sodium hydroxide or sodium oxide, same reaction will take place, because sodium oxide is also considered as base. So during the reaction, NaCl and water will form as product. NaCl is salt and H2O is water. So in every neutralization reaction, whenever acid reacts with base, always salt and water forms. For balancing here, we need to write 2 with HCl to balance hydrogen, and 2 with sodium oxide, and 2 with NaCl. Now this equation is balanced. So neutralization reaction is a reaction in which acid reacts with base and always form salt and water through double displacement reaction. Let's see some more examples of neutralization reaction. This is the formula of sulfuric acid H2SO4 and potassium hydroxide KOH. Sulfuric acid is acid, potassium hydroxide is base. When these two react with each other, double displacement reaction takes place like this. You can easily make the formula of product by drawing arrows. So product formula will be KSO4 according to these arrows and H2O. But here, for correct formula, you need to use valency. Here the formula of salt is not correct. So after writing product, you must have to check the formula of salt according to valency. Valency of potassium is +1. Valency of sulfate ion is -2. So for making formula, their valencies will interchange. The formula of this salt will be K2SO4. Without sign, their valencies will be interchanged. This is the method to write correct formula for any chemical compound. Now this is the formula of salt, A2SO4 and H2O is water. You need to balance the equation because you can see here potassium is not balanced. In product, there are two potassium atoms. On reactant side, there is only one potassium atom. So for balancing, you need to write 2 here with KOH as well as 2 with water molecules to balance hydrogen now. For writing correct equation for any neutralization reaction, you need to follow simple 3 steps. Step number 1 is write the product according to double displacement reaction. Then make the correct formula of product or salt. At the end, you need to balance the equation. If you'll follow these simple 3 steps, you can easily write neutralization equation for neutralization reaction, for any neutralization reaction. Let's do one more. HNO3, which is known as nitric acid, and magnesium hydroxide, which is known as a base. When these two react with each other, follow simple 3 steps to write equation. First of all, according to double displacement reaction, you need to make the formula of salt. Formula of salt will be MgNO3, and you know the formula of water, H2O. In formula of water also, valencies have been used here because oxygen valency is 2 and hydrogen valency is 1. So this formula is made according to the valencies. Now you need to make correct formula of salt or product. Magnesium valency is +2, nitrate valency is -1. When these valencies will interchange, the formula of this salt will be MgNO3 2. But this 2 will look like 32. To make it different from the previous 3, we will write or insert a bracket over here. This will show this 2 we have written to make the correct formula. This is not the part of nitrate ion formula. Now follow the third step, balance the equation. First of all, you have to balance metal, which is magnesium, it is already balanced. Now you need to balance non-metal, and for balancing nitrogen or N, you need to write 2 here with acids, HNO3. Now you need to balance hydrogen and at the end oxygen. For balancing hydrogen, you will write 2 here with water also. Now if you will count oxygen, oxygens are already balanced here. Now this is the next reaction of acid, reaction with metals. In this reaction, particular gas is released. Let's see how these reactions take place. HCl is an acid and magnesium is a metal. When HCl reacts with magnesium, negative radical of acid combines with metal and it will form through single displacement reaction. These types of reactions are single displacement reaction. Replacement of one ion is taking place here. So the formula of product will be MgCl and H2. Here hydrogen gas will release. MgCl is the formula of salt and H2 is the formula of hydrogen gas. Now for correct formula, use valency. You need to make the correct formula of salt now. Valency of magnesium is +2 and valency of chlorine is -1. So the formula of this salt will be MgCl2. When these valencies will interchange, the formula will become Mg1Cl2. We usually don't write 1, so formula will be MgCl2 only. Now follow the third step for balancing. You need to balance Cl here and hydrogen as well. So for balancing, you need to write 2 here only with HCl. So whenever any acid reacts with metal, always salt and hydrogen gas form. Hydrogen gas will release. So with the release of this hydrogen gas, you can recognize the reaction is taking place. और इफ एसिड इज अननोन टू यू यू कैन रिकॉग्नाइज द प्रेजेंस ऑफ एनी एसिड इन एनी सब्सटेंस. हाइड्रोजन कैन बी टेस्टेड बाय दिस मेथड. इफ यू बर्न अ मैच स्टिक नियर हाइड्रोजन गैस इट विल बर्न विद पॉप साउंड. हाइड्रोजन गैस कैरेक्टरिस्टिक इज दैट इट बर्न्स विद पॉप साउंड. सो विद दिस साउंड यू कैन रिकॉग्नाइज दैट दिस इज हाइड्रोजन गैस रिलीजिंग. Let's see another example of these types of reaction. Sulfuric acid H2SO4 when reacts with metal sodium. N is the symbol for sodium. Through single displacement reaction, this reaction will take place. Negative ion. The ion which is written except for hydrogen in the formula of acid. Hold this ion will combine with metal. So formula of the salt form will be Na2SO4 and H2 is hydrogen gas. Na2SO4 is salt and H2 is hydrogen gas. Now here you can see 2 is written due to the valency of sulfate ion. Now for balancing we will write 2 with sodium metal. Hydrogen is already balanced here. Now try this equation by yourself. H3PO4 which is the formula of phosphoric acid and Ca which is the formula of calcium metal. When these two react, what will form? What will be the formula of products? This you have to identify. To know the correct answer, watch the video till end. Now let's study the next type of reaction. Next reaction of acid with carbonate or bicarbonate salts. In this reaction also a particular gas is released. Through this gas we can recognize the presence of acid or the formation or the we can recognize that reaction is taking place. Carbonates are basically CO3 minus 2 radical. Minus 2 is the charge on carbonate radical. CO3 is the formula of carbonate. And bicarbonate is HCO3 with minus 1 charge. Let's see when acid reacts with any salt of carbonate, it always forms salt, carbon dioxide and water. Similarly, when acid reacts with any salt of bicarbonate, it forms salt, carbon dioxide and water. In both the cases, products will be same. Let's see a real example. HCl is an acid. Na2CO3 is sodium carbonate, is a carbonate salt. When these two will react, salt, carbon dioxide and water will form. So the formula of salt will be made like this. Any radical cation attached with carbonate ion will combine with anion attached in acid to make the formula of salt. So formula of salt will be NaCl. Carbon dioxide formula is CO2 and H2O is water. So salt, carbon dioxide and water has formed. Now here you can see equation is not balanced, but the formula of salt is correct. The valency of sodium is plus 1, chlorine radical is minus 1. So formula is correct. Now you need to balance the equation. For balancing sodium, you need to write 2 with NaCl and 2 with HCl. Now here the equation is balanced. Let's see the same example with bicarbonate salt. HCl is acid and NaHCO3. Sodium bicarbonate is a bicarbonate salt. Na2CO3, sodium carbonate, is also known as washing soda, and NaHCO3, sodium bicarbonate, is known as baking soda. When these two will react, formula of salt will be the same. Through same method, it will be made NaCl, CO2 and H2O. Here you can see products are same, but the difference is here you don't need to balance the equation. NaCl is the formula of salt. No balancing is required because sodium is already balanced and hydrogen is also balanced. In these reactions, carbon dioxide gas is released. You can easily check the release of carbon dioxide gas with through either bubbles or effervescence, or you can use a burning match stick to check carbon dioxide. So if the presence of carbon dioxide confirmed, then the formation or presence of HCl or acids is also confirmed. Now complete these by yourself. When phosphoric acid reacts with magnesium carbonate, what will be the formula of product, or what will form? When nitric acid reacts with magnesium bicarbonate, what will be the product? And acetic acid reacts with potassium carbonate. Identify the product and complete these equations by yourself. Remember three steps to complete these equations. First, you need to write products, then make the correct formula of product, then at the end you have to balance the equation. Watch full video to know the correct equations at the end. The fourth reaction of acid is reactions with sulfide or bisulfide salts. In these reactions also, a particular gas is released. Sulfide radical is SO3 with minus 2 sign, and bisulfide is HSO3 with minus sign. So let's see when acid reacts with these types of salts, what happens. Acids when react with sulfide salts, always salt, sulfur dioxide and water are formed. Here sulfur dioxide gas is released. Same reaction will take place with bisulfide salts. Whenever acid reacts with bisulfide salts, salt, sulfur dioxide and water will form. Let's see the example. HCl is an acid, K2SO3, potassium sulfide is a sulfide salt. Through the same method, formula of salt you can write. So the formula of salt will be KCl, sulfur dioxide formula is SO2, and water formula you know H2O. So KCl is salt, so here you don't need to make the correct formula for salt because it is already corrected formula. Potassium valency is plus 1, chloride valency is minus 1. So formula of KCl salt will be K1Cl1, simply KCl. But you need to balance this equation. Potassium is not balanced here. So for balancing potassium, you will write 2 with KCl and HCl. So it is balanced now. Let's see the same reaction with bisulfide salt. When HCl acid reacts with potassium bisulfide, through same method the formula of salt can be made. So product will be same, KCl plus SO2 plus H2O. KCl is salt here with the correct formula. Now if you need to do balancing here, you can check, but here no balancing is required. Sulfur dioxide gas is because non-metallic gas and non-metallic gases are acidic in nature. So it can turn blue litmus paper red. So if you are performing this reaction in any test tube, the release of sulfur dioxide gas can be confirmed by using a blue litmus paper. Now try these equations by yourself. Phosphoric acid combines with barium sulfide. What will be the product? Nitric acid combines with barium bisulfide. What will be the product? And carbonic acid. Sorry, oxalic acid when combined with potassium sulfide. Identify the product. Remember to follow these three simple steps. Write product, make correct formula and balance the equation. Watch with full video to know the correct equations. Now next type of reaction of acid is reactions with sulfides. In these reactions also particular gas is released. Sulfide is H minus 2 radical. Now, whenever acid react with such type of compounds which are known as sulfides, what will happen? Let's see. HCl is acid, FeS is iron sulfide. When this reaction takes place, H combines with S and Cl combines with Fe. Means here, double displacement reaction is taking place. So through double displacement reaction, the product will be FeCl and H2S because the valency of sulfur is minus 2 hydrogen plus 1. So formula of HS hydrogen sulfide will be H2S. So here, salt will form and hydrogen sulfide gas will release always in such type of reactions. For making correct formula of salt, FeCl, you need to know the valency of Fe and Cl. Here the valency of Fe is plus 2. From reactant you can identify the valency of iron. Because iron is transition metal having variable valency. It is written with S, valency of S sulfide is minus 2. So FeS is written means here iron valency must be plus 2. Therefore no number is written in this formula. So valency of iron is plus 2. Chloride valency is minus 1. So formula of this salt will be FeCl2. At the end you need to balance the equation. For balancing equation you will write 2 with HCl. So in these type of reactions, whenever acid reacts with sulfide compound, always salt and hydrogen sulfide gas is released. The smell of hydrogen sulfide gas is like rotten egg smell. So through this smell, you can recognize the release of hydrogen sulfide gas. Let's see one more example. Whenever sulfuric acid reacts with sodium sulfide. Sulfuric acid is acid and sodium sulfide is sulfide compound. So when these two react with each other, they will form through double displacement reaction salt and hydrogen sulfide gas. The formula of salt will be Na2SO4 because SO4 valency is minus 2 and sodium valency is plus 1. Now try this by yourself. Phosphoric acid when combines with calcium sulfide, phosphoric acid H3PO4 is acid and CaS is calcium sulfide. What will be the product? Identify this. So these were all reactions of acid. Now I have told you that at the end I'll tell you the correct equations. So here I'm going to tell you correct equations. First of all, I ask you this equation to complete. So the correct, you must have written these equations. So that you can check from here, the correct equation or product for this equation will be Ca3PO42 and H2 hydrogen gas, because this is a reaction of acid with metal. So here salt and hydrogen gas should release. For making correct formula of salt, I have written Ca3PO42 because the valency of calcium is 2 and phosphate ion valency is 3. So according to the valency, the formula will be this. At the end, I have balanced the equation by writing 3 here. So calcium has been balanced. For balancing PO4 radical, I have written 2 here. And for balancing hydrogen at the end, I have written 3 here. Next equation which I asked was H3PO4 plus MgCO3 and products will be Mg3PO42 plus carbon dioxide and water because this is a reaction of acid with carbonate salt. Correct formula of product salt will be Mg3PO42 according to the valency of both these species. For balancing I have written 2 with acid, 3 with carbonate salt, 3 with carbon dioxide to balance carbon and 3 with water. Next equation was nitric acid with magnesium bicarbonate. Here also carbon dioxide gas will release with the formation of salt and water. The formula of salt will be MgNO3 2 because the valency of NO3 is minus 1 and magnesium is plus 2. For balancing, I have written two here, and two here with water. Next equation was acetic acid with potassium carbonate, and the products will be potassium acetate, CH3COOK, carbon dioxide, and water. From acetic acid, only the last H is ionized, so it will remove, and here cation from carbonate salt will come and attach. For balancing, I have written 2 with acetic acid and 2 with potassium acetate. Few more equations I gave you. Phosphoric acid with barium sulfide. Products will be barium phosphate, sulfur dioxide gas, and water, because this is the reaction of acid with sulfide salt. So a salt, sulfur dioxide, and water should form. Next equation was nitric acid with barium bisulfide, and products are barium nitrate, sulfur dioxide, and water. Here I have used simple 3 steps. First I wrote the formula of salt, then I corrected the formula according to the valency, and at the end I have balanced the equation. Check your equations with these equations. Next equation was oxalic acid with potassium sulfide, and the products will be potassium oxalate, K2C2O4, SO2, and water, H2O. The last equation which I gave you is phosphoric acid with calcium sulfide. The products will be calcium phosphate and hydrogen sulfide gas. Correct formula of salt will be CH3 because the valency of phosphate is 3, PO42 because the valency of calcium is 2. For balancing this equation, I have written 2 here, 3 here, and 3 here. I hope you have written the correct equation. But if you have to ask anything, you can ask in comment section. If you understood everything, please like this video and subscribe my channel for more videos. Thank you, and Allah Hafiz.